or is that molded?
Yeah, so that'll be molded. It'll be like indented. So when we...
If this is the Earth with its shadow, the Sun is in that direction, and here is the Moon with its shadow, and often they're not lined up top to bottom, and so the shadows miss each other, but if you happen to get them lined up top to bottom, you can have the Moon pass through the shadow of the Earth and have a lunar eclipse, or you can actually have the Moon on this side and just a little tiny bit of the Earth, not much in fact, could possibly be fully shaded. Shadow actually covers more than the entire continent. So this is actually good news. That means that the entire continent of North America will be in partial shadow, but there's only a very small amount that will actually be in total shadow, as you may have already realized. So here's another illustration. Basically, here is the partial shadow. It goes all the way out here. It goes all the way above Canada. And so if you're here in the Twin Cities, for instance, the coverage of the disk of the sun will be about 85%. I've heard numbers between 80 and 90%, but 85%, that's a pretty good bet. Here's the problem, though, and that's, in fact, it passes south of Iowa. You have to get into Missouri or into Nebraska. I'll be heading to Nebraska myself to actually see this. Totality. There will be plenty of an event here, but totality is something special. How many people have seen a total solar eclipse? Oh, man. I'm looking forward to it. I really am. Okay. So the last time there was a coast-to-coast eclipse of this sort was 1918, a long time ago. Okay. In fact, here is 100 years worth of paths of totality for North America. So if I look from 1951 to 2000, I see them for 2,000 months from 50 balloons in a row. It's not going to work. But some of it will work. I'm putting big money on it's not all going to work. But we've learned a lot, and the people who have been watching us have learned a lot. And if you watch us during the eclipse day, you'll learn something. Okay, so here we go. I have to give kudos to the Montana...